Well, we're on the reference floor at the Thomas Crane Public Library's main branch in Quincy Center to learn all about their microfilm center. Teresa Tangney is here to give us a little demonstration. Hey, Teresa.
Hi, thanks for coming over.
Thanks for having us. When I first heard about microfilm, I thought of the old-fashioned microfiche machines that you would scroll through the actual film with the big monitor in front of you. And this is nothing like that.
No, we still do have two of those, okay. But this is our brand new fancy version of that.
Ah.
So we're very excited to have it.
Okay.
So we're just really unrolling it this week, so nobody's really played with it yet, so it's brand new.
Okay, well that's exciting. What was the thought process for bringing this over?
Well, we're the only library in the area that has the Patriot Ledger on microfilm, starting in 1837, so that's when it was the Quincy Patriot, and then eventually it went to be the Patriot Ledger, but we're the only library that has it, and we get requests for it all the time. People doing local history, genealogy, any kind of projects still need to use the microfilm very regularly. So right now we have two of the older machines, but they're in use constantly, and they don't really have a lot of features. So if you're trying to lighten up a photo or you're trying to crop anything, you have to do that all manually. You have to print out from the other machines, do all that, scan it. This you can do everything right from this machine.
Oh, all right. So is it just the Patriot Ledger that is here, or is it any?
No, we have the Quincy Sun dating from 1969, and we also have the Boston Globe 1971 to 2010.
Okay.
And we have a variety of magazines as well.
All right.
And they're all housed up on this floor.
Oh, okay. So and it's all kind of digitized microfilm, I guess.
It is, yeah. And because the Patriot Ledger isn't technically digitized, this is the only way to access it.
Oh,
a lot of other newspapers you can search online, but the Patriot Ledger is not one of them.
Right.
So, like I was showing you earlier, we still use this card catalog right behind us to look up articles in the Patriot Ledger, and then you have to go to the microfilm and find them.
Wow, okay, so that is a bit of old school for
it
sure.
It is. It's a challenge, but it's the kind of challenge we like. So.
Okay, so can you show us how it works?
Sure. So when you open up the software, it's going to ask you to choose which kind of film you're using, and pretty much everything we have here is this 35mm film.
Okay.
We also have microfiche, and we have a couple 16mm, but this is going to be the one that most people choose.
Okay.
Sometimes people do bring in their own microfiche organizations that have old records, and they'll be able to easily access that on this machine. It's
a little
more difficult on the older machines, but this will make it much easier.
So do they need a staff member such as yourself to help them with this?
When I think probably the first couple times people use it, they'll need kind of a tutorial on how to use it, just because it's so different than the older machines, but it's very easy to use once you get the hang of it.
Okay.
This is a password protected computer too, so anybody that wants to use it will have to see us at the reference desk before they come in.
Okay.
So I already have the microfilm loaded on here,
but
normally what you would do is you'd pull this all the way out here,
And
this guide pops up on the screen that shows you how to load the microfilm,
which
is kind of nice, because if somebody was coming over here, you know, and they weren't too familiar with it, it just guides you through it very easily.
Right.
And that's when the buttons pop up to scroll through the film at high speed. So if you were going to the middle of the month, you could use the high speed so you don't have to sit and page through.
Oh, gotcha. Okay.
And then when you push that in, you'll see that the image appears on the screen and that guide disappears and you just have your options here.
So where do these films come from?
They're all right behind us
here
on the shelves, and some of them are in a cabinet in the back corner.
Oh, right.
But if somebody comes in and they're asking for something, we'll be happy to show them.
Okay, good.
And so this green box over here is kind of, it's very important because that's how you're going to crop, that's how you're going to adjust your photo, anything. So whatever's in the green box is what these controls over here are going to fix.
I gotcha, okay.
And the best one on here, there's an auto adjust and focus button. It's right down here.
Okay.
And that will auto straighten, it'll make the brightness a little bit better, and it will crop it automatically depending on where you have this box.
Great.
So you can kind of see that when it pops up. And I chose this roll of film because there's kind of a funny story on here about Ramek's department store.
Oh, sure, yeah.
And at one point they had monkeys in the store in the 50s,
really?
And one of the monkeys got loose. So this article here is about the monkeys in the store, and I'll show you how the magnifier works so you can see a little bit of that.
Okay.
So there's a magnifier option right here, and this will zoom in on the page, and you'll see that this blue box pops up right here on the screen, and that's the area that it's magnifying. So you can move this whole box right over here, and then as you drag the box, it shows you, it zooms in on the column. So if you're searching, you know, up and down a page, it's much easier to focus if you use that magnifier.
Great.
And then if you make it a little bit larger, it's a little bit easier to see here. I can zoom right in on that photo of the monkey. And this is also the best feature, I think, of this is that you can spot edit photos. On the old microfilm, you just had to depend on how the printer was feeling that day as to how it would come out. But with this, you can brighten it. You just use the spot edit tool.
Okay.
And then you can adjust the brightness right around it with this little brightness button.
So very user-friendly, it seems.
It is. So then you can kind of click and hold, and you'll see the brightness number is going up.
Oh, yeah.
And you'll see in a second the picture
brightens
up.
Wow.
You can adjust
Big
the
difference.
Contrast.
Okay. Yep.
So this is also really good if you're looking for a wedding announcement.
Yep.
Sometimes people come in and they want to give their parents an anniversary present, something like that.
Oh, yeah.
And the photo quality isn't always that great. We used to be able to get the photos right from the Patriot Ledger, but we can't do that anymore. So this is the only way to get them.
Oh, all right.
So this is an amazing feature. And people can just email the PDFs to themselves mm-hmm. right from this computer, and that wasn't the case before.
Mm-hmm.
And you can also print them directly to our print system over there,
okay.
and it's 15 cents a copy to print.
And you can take it and frame it and do whatever you want with it? Okay.
So another feature of this is that you can use, we have something called info link on here, so if you're unfamiliar with a word that pops up,
mm-hmm.
you can click on this info link button. And then you can highlight a word, and it will pop up, and you can use Google, Wikipedia, and it will automatically look it up for you.
Oh, how about that? That's a great feature.
Pretty cool.
Yeah. Okay.
And you can highlight more than one word, too, if there was a whole string that you were looking for.
Okay. So this toolbar to the left here is critical.
It's everything.
Yeah.
And we tried to put most of the buttons on the home screen, so you shouldn't have to tab around too much on here.
Right.
If you loaded the microfilm wrong
mm-hmm.
and it was backwards,
mm-hmm.
which happens a lot with our reels, now you can just click this mirror button here and it fixes it automatically.
No kidding.
Before
okay.
you'd have to unreel the whole thing and put
right.
it back on, and it would take a good deal of time.
Okay.
So this is
it's a
good feature. You can just fix it automatically.
Fantastic.
You can also rotate the page with these buttons here.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You can scan to a flash drive, which hooks in right here.
Oh, okay.
So there are a lot of cool features. And if you are scanning a couple pages, you can scan it as a multi-page PDF, so you can kind of load everything onto one file and then send it through email.
Okay.
Because this computer has the internet on it, too. It's hooked up to our public Wi-Fi, so you just have to agree to our terms when you log into it, but then you're good to send things
wow.
through email.
Okay. Is there any kind of time limit, Teresa, on how long you can spend on this system?
No time
no?
limit.
Okay.
No, we have people that sit at the microfilm readers for hours,
okay.
depending on what they're looking for. Some
yeah.
people are doing long-term projects, so that takes longer. And at first, I think it'll take people a little while to get used to
mm-hmm.
this, but it's definitely a great improvement over
yeah.
what we had before.
Do you need to reserve time to use it? Just come in?
Yep.
Okay.
Check in at the reference desk for the password, and then you're off.
Okay. And I'm assuming you can print also.
You can print, yep. It's
yep.
15 cents a page, and
okay.
it goes right to our public printer.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And
you can also crop. So if you just wanted, say you wanted just the article about Remix here,
yeah.
you can move your green box.
Mm-hmm.
Let me just close this here. Can move your green box around it, and if you right-click, you'll see that it's going to crop it automatically for you here
mm-hmm,
into
mm-hmm.
the corner. Before, you'd have to take a pair of scissors and cut it out yourself. So,
oh, right,
you
yeah.
know, once you printed it out, so that's a nice feature.
Yeah.
And then if you scan it to drive one, it will save it to this computer, and it will ask you to give it a name, and you can choose your file format. So it's really great if you're just doing a picture and you want to send it as a JPEG,
right.
you can choose that. And it will save it to a folder right on this computer, so you can email it, print, or save to a flash drive.
Okay. Wow, it's mm-hmm. very versatile. Is this the way kind of libraries are going?
Is
this?
It is.
This is, yeah,
it is.
The wave
yeah.
of the future
mm-hmm.
here. And you're on the cutting edge.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for showing it to us.
Thank you.
Looks like a lot of fun to play with and explore, and I'm sure your members will get a lot of use out of it.
Thanks.
You are welcome. And if you'd like to get more information about this or any programs at the library, don't forget to visit their website, thomascranelibrary.org.